Whenever I talk about Minecraft's combat to anyone, I see a rather interesting pattern. Usually, anyone that played before 1.9, the combat update, has a tendency to miss the old PvP, while agreeing that the new combat system is better. It may just be my group of friends, but I honestly agree, even if it might be a hot take. Clickfest equals better didn't feel like the best game design choice when the topic is combat, so the added cooldown to weapons, the shields, and other mechanics included in the whole update were healthy towards making the combat skill based instead of relying entirely on click speed. But although it brought its own benefits, this new PvP is way slower than the old one, and I don't want to like a slow paced battle. My favorite combat system, for example, and it's not a PvP game, but hear me out, is Sekiro's. I think the pacing at which it plays out feels very nice. It's not impossible to follow, but you can't miss a second either without being punished for it. I'd honestly like to make Minecraft PvP more enjoyable for those who like fast-paced combat such as myself, and I know just the guy that could do that. Me. So welcome, I'm Ghosty, and today I'll be showing you through the process of making Minecraft's combat a little pacier. First off, the tools I'm gonna use. I haven't ever gotten into modding, since I didn't know Java or any programming language close to it up until recently, so that's out of the question. The same thing applies to making plugins, since they do use Java. And if you've ever tried using command blocks to make anything in this game, you'd know how hellish it is to use those. So I went for my best option, which is to use a plugin called Denizen that allows me to write very powerful scripts in a language way simpler than Java. Together with it, I'm using MythicMobs, which, in addition to making mobs, allows me to make better particle effects really easily. So I downloaded PaperMC, downloaded those plugins, added a few things, then got to work. The exact plan is to add new skills to each weapon so that they make the player have to make decisions during the combat, which, although it may not make it objectively faster, it makes it feel much faster, since there are more things happening. But before adding those skills, I have to find a way to not let them be spammed or abused in any way. And so I had two options. I could either use a cooldown system, which I've used in another PvP mode I made a while back, or I could use a mana system, which would be an extra resource that the player has to manage while fighting. Personally, I've noticed that cooldown systems tend to drag fights out for way too long, since when a player is low in health, his first instinct is to run until his skills recharge. And as for a mana resource, I would need it to recharge in some way other than just waiting, as it would create the very same problem. After thinking for a bit, I ended up with this. This is the energy bar. It is the resource you use when casting any skill, and if you don't have enough of it, well, good luck. For it to recharge, you have to engage in combat, which means either getting hit or hitting someone. This makes sure that running won't be that helpful if you are just stalling until the skill recharges. Alright, base of the system done, let's get to the fun stuff. Absolutely pulverizing our enemy's attacks. So, you remember how I was talking about Sekiro? Yeah, you hear this good crunchy sound of hitting many consecutive parries. What about we do that? When holding a sword, you can right click to start a parry skill. This skill makes you invulnerable to whatever damage you receive for a moment, as long as you're looking towards the source of the damage. Do you want to parry an iron golem's punch? You can. What about an arrow? You better time it right. What about something more destructive? What about parrying the warden's sonic boom? Well, go on. The only thing you have to be truly aware of are players, as they can not only react to your parries by letting it fade away, but also use bash on your parry. What is bash, you ask? Bash is a brutal skill that, with the right tier of X, can deal up to 8.5 hearts of damage in a single hit. While the parry has a small window of protection, bash has a delay before attacking. Once you right click with an X, the skill will wind up and then hit like a truck. What you just saw was a stance break. In some conditions, a weapon can straight up delete 50 energy points. So be careful, you don't want to play with parrying too much against diamond or the right axis. The best way to deal with bashes is to quickly gain distance from your enemy, which is where the next skill becomes useful. Quick draw is a skill that allows you to either instantly shoot your bow or shoot your crossbow without any need to reload. So, if you like bow spamming, this might be an option for a moment. And I really mean just a moment, or else you might destroy your own energy. And how to counter those? Well, easy! If they're spamming, you can get their timing. If you get their timing, you can parry them. And then you get close, and you kill them. Those are all the skills I've made for now, but each of them has a few differences depending on weapon materials, which I'll be going through right now. Weapons are divided by materials, each material going from a tier 1 to 4. Those that don't have different materials, such as bows and crossbows, are tierless, as their skills have no variations. For tier 1, we have wooden and stone weapons. This tier is more expensive energy-wise and tends to have worse timings than tier 2, which is considered to be the basic tier. Tier 2 consists of iron and golden swords and axes. They are the base of weapon balancing, since you'll be using them the most. They are generally better than tier 1, of course, but they have no extra effects on their skills. Diamond and netherite are tier 3 and 4, respectively. Those two tiers have different advantages for each skill. Parries start dealing energy damage on those who are parried, and on tier 4, 3 consecutive parries break the stance of the enemy. For bashes, tier 3 starts breaking the stance of those who parry it, and tier 4 is way cheaper, enough to let you use it 3 times when at full energy. All you've seen here is just the base for my full PvP extension. There are many features I want to add, such as extra items that give different skills when on the left hand, special weapons with magic powers, and even different combat styles that can be unlocked. So, if you'd like any of those things, please let me know in the comments of this video. I will eventually release this extension to the public, so be sure to subscribe to be notified whenever this happens. Please leave a like on this video, and I'll see you on the next one.